Nandasya Khyananjana Shalakaya Chaksurunmilitan Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prestaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swami Niti Namane Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Precharine Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschachyate Satarine Jaya Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadata Shri Vasade Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we are continuing to hear about talks between King Rahugana and Jad Bharat. Maharaj Rahugana, remember, he was the king and he was going to visit holy places being carried in a palanquin. And Jad Bharat, actually the name Jada means somebody who is very stupid, who has no proper brain.
Jada Bharat. 这个其中的家的意思是这个人非常的愚钝，大脑不怎么聪明，很迟钝的一个人。So,
but actually, this Jad Bharat was a very great personality. He was a self-realized soul.
而事实上，这个Jad Bharat 他是一个非常伟大的人物，他是一个伟大的灵魂。In
his previous life, he had been king, a great king, powerful king of the planet, known Maharaj Bharat. And the whole planet was named after him. Planet was called Bharat Varsha.
这个星球的名字被称为Bharatvarsha.
Even today in India, if you buy the postage stamps, you'll see they write on the postage stamp. They don't put India, they'll put Bharat. They call the country as Bharat.
即便在当今的这个印度，你如果去买那个邮票的话，上面还写的不是这个印度，写的是Bharat这个国家。
So Jad Bharat was taken to carry the palanquin for the king. But Jad Bharat was not able to carry the palanquin like other people because he was very careful not to step on insects. So the king was insulting Jad Bharat and he was telling him, you know, you're a stupid person and I'm going to beat you if you don't carry the palanquin properly.
这个时候，这个国王就开始指责这个加德巴拉特，觉得他很愚笨、很愚蠢。如果你很不好好的抬轿子的话，我将抽打你、鞭打你。
But then Jad Bharat began to speak philosophy to the king, and he revealed himself as being a very great soul.
这个时候, Jad Bharat 就开始给这个国王讲述哲学。 与此同时呢, 这个 Rahuga 他就发现这个 Jad Bharat 是一个伟大的灵魂。
And then the king became very sorry that he had offended Jad Bharat.
于是这个国王就感觉到非常的抱歉，他觉得他冒犯了这个加德巴拉特。
And he knew that to offend a great soul is to offend a great devotee is very serious.
因为他知道，如果冒犯了一个伟大的灵魂，一个伟大的奉献者，是一个很严肃的事情，很严重的事情。
So he begged forgiveness from Jad Bharat.
所以他祈求加德巴拉的原谅。
And Jad Bharat then went on to give him instruction.
加德巴拉就继续给他一些训示。And
he was telling him about the nature of the material world.
他给他讲述这个物质世界的本性。
Jad Bharat wants to enlighten the king. He wants to reveal to the king the true nature of the material world. Maharaj Rahugan is a king, so he's been living in luxury, he's been surrounded by opulence and has many servants.
因为他是一个国王，所以他周围有很多的财富，有很多的仆人，还有很好的这个物质条件。And
Maharaj and Jad Bharat in his previous birth, he had also been a king, but he had given up, he had renounced being a king.
Jad Bharat 在他的上一世也是一个国王。 但是呢,他放弃了这个国王的王位,他放弃了这一切,变得非常的气绝。
He had understood the danger of living in luxury and opulence, surrounded by wealth and women.
他理解到,如果一个人处在富裕的环境下, 有很多的仆人,有很多的财富, 有很多的这种 物质优越的条件是非常危险的一种状况。So
Jad Bharat is spending time to explain to Maharaj Rahugan about the nature of the material world.
所以Jad Bharat就花了一些时间给他讲述物质世界的这个本性。And
he tells him, he gives an example about how a merchant goes into the forest to try to find something, looking for something of value, which he can trade in the market and earn some money for himself.
他就描述这个物质世界有时候就像一个商人，他试图翻山越岭，但是这个山上有很多的荆棘布满，他想在这个山上获得一些东西，然后到市场上拿去卖，但是这个山上布满了荆棘。
So he tells Jad Bharat about how the merchant, this man, sometimes goes to the forest, and in the forest he may have to climb some mountain. But on the mountain there are many small stones, sharp stones, and there are many thorns, and they prick his feet and make it very difficult for him.
然后到山上，这个山上呢有很多的这个小石头，这些小石头足以能够把这个足你的脚给划破。然后这个山里面呢还有很多的荆棘，所以呢要去到这个山里面是充满了很多的这种痛苦的。The man
in the material world, He's naturally, he wants to be happy and he wants to provide for his family.
在这个物质世界的人呢, 他都想获得快乐, 然后同时他也想为自己的家人提供这个快乐。
And he wants to also, he wants to become very important in the society. He wants to be famous.
他也想在这个社会和这个家庭之中变得很重要，特别是想在这个社会想变得很出名。
So we see in material world that although everybody wants to be happy, practically nobody is happy. Everybody is miserable.
我们看到所有的人尽管都想获得快乐，但是每一个人都非常的困惑，非常的难受。
It's very difficult to keep the family satisfied.
要想让这个家庭获得满意。是非常非常难的一件事情。
And Prabhupada gave the example how in the Western countries today, practically there's no family life.
Prabhupada 也给出了一个例子说，在西方的国家基本上没有这种家庭的生活可言。
It used to be in Western countries, they would build homes, they'd build houses for the family.That the husband
and... 这个或许在西方国家以前、
Go ahead.
在以前的西方国家可能会有一些家庭生活，但是现在没有这种家庭生活。
So they would build the house, they make the home, so that the husband and wife and the family could all live there.
他们想、建一个家庭，建立一个，有一个家，然后想让自己的家人住在这个房子里面，得到庇护。
Yeah, the home would be big enough for the whole family to live there.
这个家足够让所有的人都住在这个里面。
But if you look at cities today in the West, many of the houses, many of the apartments, they're only big enough for one person or for two people.
但是你看一看，现在的一些的，一些家庭的这个家庭状况，他们的那个房子只是够一个人住在这个里面。刚刚就是讲以前的这个家，它可以让很多的人住在里面，但是现在的这个家只够一个人住在里面。
Yeah, one person, or sometimes, of course, the one person will bring his friend. One woman is there, she'll bring her man.Or one man is there, he will bring his woman. The couple, you know, they will stay there.
有些时候，男的带一个朋友过来，女的带一个朋友过来，就是说这个家，
And often they live together without marriage. They don't have any children.
他们生活在一起住着，但是呢，他们没有这种实际的婚姻，因为他们也没有孩子。
And they don't want children.
他们不想要孩子。
And in order to avoid children, they'll take advantage of the modern systems. They do things, they have special medicine, special pills to take so the woman will not get pregnant or some other device.
为了，就是说，为了不要孩子，他们借助现在社会的一些工具和方法，比如说这个女性可以吃一些药丸，或者是怎么样，让她不有孩子，没有孩子。
People, normal people are happy to get children. They feel it's a blessing to be given a child.
通常情况下。人们对于要孩子是一个非常快乐的事情，他们觉得有了孩子是得到一件
，But today
享受这个愉悦的过程，很愉悦，很快乐。
But today people are so demonic, they're so demonic and atheistic that they don't like children, they don't want children.
但是现在的人们呢，都非常恶魔的心态和无神论的这种心态，他们都不想要孩子。
They don't want to have a family. They just want to be alone.
他们不想要一个家庭，他们只想一个人住着。
So this is the hellish kind of civilization which has developed in the Kali Yuga. But actually, family life is something which is very necessary, and family life is there in the spiritual world. In the spiritual world, there is the family, there's the family in the home of Nanda Maharaj and all the friends and associates of Nanda Maharaj. And Krishna consciousness is to prepare us for family life. For the real family life in the spiritual world.
或者说是真正的这种灵性的家庭生活在灵性世界。
So sometimes when the man is in the forest, there will be dangerous creatures like big snakes, like a python, who may can swallow the man, or they wrap themselves around the man and crush the body of the man.
在这个物质森林之中呢, 有些时候也会有一些很可怕的一些动物 比如说这个大蟒蛇 它会突然把这个人给吞噬掉
And sometimes the poison snakes, there will be poisonous snakes there that will bite him.
或者说有一些毒蛇 它会咬这个人 让你中毒身亡
And when they bite, then the man will become unconscious almost. And the danger is that he may fall because he's in so much pain and so much difficulty, he may fall into the bottom of a well.
因为呢是非常危险的，他有可能会掉入黑井一般。
So if he falls in the well in the forest, there's nobody there to save him.
如果他在这个森林里面掉到黑井里面去的，没有人会救你，基本上是没有希望的。
So this unconscious condition is like deep sleep.
这种没有意识的状态，有些时候，也就像属于深睡的这个状态之中。
So people are asleep in the material world, they're asleep. They have no knowledge of spiritual life.
在物质世界的人们睡觉，因为他们睡觉的时候，他们
Lord Chaitanya came to wake everyone up. He came to give them all the holy name, the chanting of the Maha Mantra, to wake them up. He's telling them, take advantage of the human life. But if you just sleep, then you will lose all the youth that you have known, you'll waste all your life. Even in the higher planets, people are in the same illusion. They don't know the real value of life.
They don't know the real value of life.
So we want people. Jad Bharat is telling Maharaj Rahugana how people just waste their life.
Jad Bharat 就告诉 Rahuga 人们是怎么样浪费生命的。
They're just like somebody just sleeping all the time.
就像有的时候人们总是在睡觉一样。
So of course, material world people try to get pleasure, and they look for pleasure from the opposite sex. The man looks for the woman.
有些时候人们想在这个物质世界获得快乐，他就想去在性的这个过程中寻求快乐。
But when he tries to find some woman, then he may get, some people may speak insulting words. They will chastise him, and they would tell him, "This, you're very lusty, you're very greedy. Why are you bought trying to take this woman?"
在这种尝试之中呢，有些时候，这个男人他去享受这种性的快乐的时候，他会遭到这个女方的侮辱和谩骂。你为什么这么的色？你为什么这样？会侮辱他和谩骂他。
So Jad Bharat said, this is just like in the forest, people go to the beehive to take the honey.
Jad Bharat 就说，这就好比在森林里面，你去想到那个蜂房里面去采蜜一样，到蜂窝那蜂房那里去采蜜一样，然后你遭到这个蜜蜂的袭击。
But when you take the honey, then the bees all come and they attack you.
当你想去抓夺取想去拿这个蜂蜜的时候，所有的蜜蜂就会来袭击你。
So the same way, the man in the material world, he may get a lot of money, and he goes and he starts spending the money.
有些时候，物质世界的人们也会得到很多的钱，他会花很多的钱去获得这种快乐。
And when he's got money, then he attracts other women, more women come.
当他真正得到这么多钱的时候，他想用这个钱来吸引更多的女人来到这里。
But then he becomes attached to the women, but then these women, they get taken away by some other man.
他想得到这个女人，但是呢，这个女人，他得到这个女人，但是这个女人又被另外的男人给劫走了。
Yeah, we see today, people may have a wife, they're not satisfied with one wife, they want many women.
我们在当今世界也看到，经常看到这样的情况：一个男人他并不满足于他自己的一个妻子，他想要很多。
Yeah, the one man may have the business. He has the business in Hong Kong, but he has a wife and family in Hong Kong, but he has another wife in China.
他或许在这个香港有一个家庭，同时呢，他在中国的大陆也有一个家庭。
Yeah, they have one wife in Beijing, another wife in Shanghai, another wife in Hangzhou.
他在这个北京有一个老婆，在上海也有个老婆，在其他城市有可能还有一个老婆。
And this way, they're trying to, they're thinking they're having a good time. They're thinking they're enjoying life.
他在筹划着，每个人都过他过得很舒服，然后呢，他也很享受现在的这样的这种生活。
Just like the man in the forest taking the honey from the bees.
但是这样的一种生活呢，是就像森林里面想去找这个蜂房一样，但是呢会被这个蜜蜂给攻击。
Yeah. And the same way the man, he's got more than one woman, more than one wife, and then the other people come, and they beat him, and they curse him, because they tell him that you're a cheater,You've got more wife, you've got your wife in Hong Kong, you've got the woman here, you've got your woman there, you're just cheating, you're a lusty dirty old man.
而这个现代社会的这个人们有了多余一，就是有了几个妻子之后，其他周围的人就会来诅咒谩骂这个人，说你这个又老又丑的这个人这么的色，你充满了这种欺骗，有了一个妻子不够，你还要这么多的妻子，你欺骗了这么多的人。
So when people have illicit sex, then they get a lot of problems. They get problems legally and illegally.
当人们有这种非法的这种性生活的时候，他会有各种各样的麻烦。他有可能犯法，有可能不，这个sorry, good day, legally and illegally.
Illegally, 不合法的，合法不合法。嗯，
合法和不合法的这种情况。
Yeah. So Prabhupada said, if we follow Krishna consciousness, we cannot have illicit sex.
所以圣帕帕德告诉我们，在这个Krishna 知觉之中，我们不应该非法性生活。
Nidashinyan Dwanla, what's wrong there? You got some microphone problem or what?
Hare Krishna.
Nidashinyan Jinchang Be Dwanla.
Jinchang Dwanla.
Hare Krishna. 对 Prabhu, 你那个声音有的时候会断续，把你的那个位置调整一下，是不是信号不太好？
OK, 好，行。
好的。
So Prabhupada said we have to be satisfied. We should be satisfied with one woman. We should be properly married and just have one wife.
圣帕帕德说，我们应该只满足于一个女人，一个妻子。
And that way it will not create any disturbance in the society.
这样的话，我们就不会对这个社会造成打扰。
And we can avoid a lot of punishment also.
We also avoid punishment.
So sometimes also, in the course of going to the forest, you will have to experience very cold, or sometimes very hot, or sometimes heavy rain.
有些时候我们在这个森林里面也会遭遇这种大雨、狂风、严寒、酷暑等这样的自然情况。
So in this way, you have to suffer so much, very difficult to tolerate all the conditions.
这种情况对于我们来说，就是要遭受很大的痛苦，我们会很难受在这种情况下。
And sometimes he tries to do business.And the people cheat him.
正如我们有的时候去做生意的时候，人们会欺骗我们。
And when they cheat each other, then they become enemies with each other.
只要我们欺骗别人或者被欺骗的时候，这个就会产生敌意，对方就是我们的敌人。
No one likes to be cheated.
没有人想被骗。
And if somebody cheats you, then certainly you won't want to keep him for a friend.
如果有人欺骗你的话，你是不会想把他继续当成你的朋友的。
So we see in the material world, because there's so much cheating, there's not very good relations between people.
因为在这个物质世界有很多的欺骗，所以人和人之间的关系并不是太好。
People are envious of each other.
人们之间充满了嫉妒。
We want to give up envy, then we can become Krishna conscious.
我们想放弃这种嫉妒，然后我们才会有 Krishna 知觉。
So in Krishna consciousness, there should not be any envy.
Krishna 之觉意味着我们没有嫉妒。
But still we see sometimes even in Krishna consciousness, people cheat and lie.
但是呢，即便在 Krishna 之觉，我们现在也会发现人们会说谎和欺骗。
So sometimes people are very eager to get money and they may not have a proper home, they may not have any place to live, they don't have a nice family enjoyment, they're not happy in the family because there's no money.
在这个物质生存的这个情况下，有些时候人们会非常贫穷。也会没有这个生活的地方，然后呢，就是他的这个各种状况都不是特别的好，生活条件很差。
So in the beginning, he goes and he tries to beg from people. He asks people to give donation, to give some money, lend some money.
开始的时候呢，他就向人们去乞讨，请你给我一点钱吧。
And when he doesn't get much money, then he may try to borrow. He may ask people, can you lend me money and I will pay you back?
当他去乞讨去要钱的时候，别人不给他的时候，他就开始向别人借钱。你能不能借我一点钱？
And then if people don't lend him money, then he will steal it from them.
而人们又不借钱给他的时候，他就开始想要偷钱。
So in this way, when he steals, then he gets caught and he gets punished.
当他要偷钱的时候，他就会遭到这个惩罚了。
So we see this world how people live. Practically nobody, very rare that people are honest.
所以我们看到这个现在的这个社会，很少有人很真实、很真诚。
They try to cheat and trick and borrow and steal.
他们想欺骗、借贷、偷取。
So nobody's peaceful.
没有人是很平和的。
Because the money problems, the exchange of money between people, because of the difficulties in money and the somebody's got money, somebody doesn't have money, so the relationships are not good.
因为在这个现在的社会，人和人之间的往来关于钱上，有些人有钱，有些人没有钱。因为这个钱的事情，人和人之间的关系并不好。
Sometimes even if they have no money, sometimes they almost die because it's so difficult for them.
有些时候人们没有钱，甚至因为没有钱而差不多快死了。
Just like
没有钱对于他们来说非常的不容易，非常的困难。
Just like at this time during the coronavirus, because many things have closed down, many businesses stopped, so people don't have any money.
就像我们现在的这个新冠疫情，有些人因为这个封闭和封锁，他基本上没有这种收入的来源，因为没有这种生意之间的往来。
So sometimes in married life also there can be problems, big problems, because of money.
即便在这个婚姻家庭生活之中，有些时候也会因为钱的这个问题而造成很多的问题。
The wife wants to maintain the home, but the husband has great difficulty where to get money.
这个妻子很想维系这个家庭，但是呢，妻子很难从她的丈夫那里得到这个钱，因为这个丈夫得到钱非常的困难。
So sometimes the situation becomes so bad that you get the tension between countries one country and another country, and then comes a war.
因为这种金钱也会导致国家和国家之间会这种关系也很紧张，甚至发生战争。
And when there's a war, then both sides suffer. Both all the people suffer on both sides.
如果国家和国家发生了战争的话，两国之间的人们都会遭受痛苦，民不聊生。
So Jabbarat tells the king about how a person in the material life, first of all, they lose their father and mother.
Jabbarat 就告诉这个国王，这个物质生活，首先呢，这个孩子，这个人会失去他的父亲和母亲。
And after they lose father and mother, then they become attached to their children.
当他失去父母之后，他就开始依附他的孩子。
And so he just changes, he tries to change his attachment from one person to another.
他只是把他的依附从一个地方转移到，从一个人的身上转移到另外一个人的身上。
And he never thinks about how to get out of the cycle of birth and death.
但是他从来没有去想过如何从这种生死的轮回之中，这种轮回之中解脱出来。
Yeah, they see that they have their children get married, and then the children have their own children, and this way they just become more and more attached to the family.
他看到他的孩子。长大了，然后结婚了，然后呢，有他自己的小孩，有他自己的家庭之后，他越来越依附于这种家庭了。
So family life is good up to a certain point, but there has to be some renunciation.
家庭生活当然非常好，但是呢，我们也需要一些弃绝的精神。
We have to prepare for the next life.
我们应该为下一生做出准备。
And to prepare for the next life, we have to practice bhakti yoga.
为了下一生做准备的话，我们得修习奉爱瑜伽。
And that means cultivating good knowledge and practicing some detachment from the material world.
修习奉爱瑜伽意味着我们得培养一些灵性的知识，以及培养一些气绝，为下一世做准备。
If they don't do that, then they're just simply going to get so much trouble.
如果他不这么做的话，他只会获得越来越多的打扰、麻烦。
So sometimes in the world, of course, there will be heroes, there will be different leaders of the country, powerful men, and people will worship them.
当然我们在这个社会上有很多的这种英雄和有力量的人，他们在这个社会上。
But these big men, although they are maybe the leader of the country,They do not have any realization. They're not spiritually advanced.
虽然他们在这个社会是英雄或者说是领导，但是呢，他们并没有灵性的知识。
Just like Mahatma Gandhi, he was the leader. He was leading India to get independence.
就像马哈塔玛玛甘地，就是甘地啊。圣雄甘地，他虽然是这个印度当时的一个领袖，但是呢，他虽然是当地是一个领袖，他教导人们开展这种独立运动。
So when India finally got independence, Prabhupada told Mahatma Gandhi. Prabhupada wrote to Mahatma Gandhi and told him, now he should preach the Bhagavad Gita.
当甘地带着人们独立之后呢，圣帕帕德给这个甘地写信说，你应该教授人们博加方歌了。现在
But Mahatma Gandhi, he just stayed in politics.
但是甘地还在处于他的，还在做一些政治上的事情。
He thought, how can my country go on without me?
他在想，如我的国家如果没有我，怎么可能呢？
So ultimately, of course, he was killed. He had to leave.
所以当然，他就被这个被杀害了。
So sometimes the man goes in the forest, and he has to.There are many wild animals. There are big lions in the forest, and he becomes very afraid of the wild animals.
人们去到森林之后，森林里面有很多的野兽。这个野兽呢，当然也会让人们感觉到非常的害怕。
And he will make friends with less harmful creatures like the birds in the forest.
Sorry,
he will make friends with the birds, some of the birds in the forest.
他会和森林里面的一些鸟结成朋友。
He thinks they will protect him from the wild animals.
就是说呢，他很害怕森林里面的这些野兽，于是呢，这个人就想和森林里面的这个小鸟结成朋友。他认为这些小鸟能够保护他。
Being afraid of the lion, when he hears the sound of the lion, he's afraid.
听到这种狮子的这种狂吼，他感到非常的害怕。
So that lion, that is like death, that is like approaching death.
这种狮吼狮子就象征了死亡。
So what he should do is take shelter of great devotees.
他应该做的是脱避于一位伟大的奉献者。
But instead, he takes shelter of people who are cheaters and who are all bogus incarnations.
但是呢，他没有这么做，他脱避的是一些欺骗者，脱避的这些人。
Yeah.Sometimes the man in the forest thinks about his wife and children, that they can protect him, they can save him from death.
有些时候人们认为他应该脱避于他的妻子和孩子，他的妻子和孩子可以保护他免受死亡。
But they cannot protect him from death.
但是他们不可以保护他免受死亡。
And the bogus, the false gurus, the false sadhus who are not really holy men but only pretending, they also cannot protect him.
还有那些假孤儒啊，假的这类灵性主义呢，也是不可能保护他免受死亡的。
So they're like some of the animals in the forest which are also eaters, like the vulture. The vulture.It's the bodies.
而这些人呢，就像森林里面那些秃鹰一样，他们也是吃人的。
So sometimes somebody may try to get the association of devotees. He tries to get away from the bogus people and come to the real people.
有些时候人们他确实和奉献者联谊，他们远离那些假的孤儒啊、假的导师啊，来到和远离他们，然后和奉献者在一起。
But when he comes to the devotees association, he finds the instructions, the instructions of the guru and the instructions of the devotees there to be too difficult for him, and he goes back again to associate with the bogus people, with the cheaters.
他来到和奉献者联谊之后，他就得到了灵性导师和一些高级奉献者的训示，但是他发现他无法遵循这些训示， 于是呢他们又 再一次返回和那些欺骗者和那些假侮辱们和物质圣经的其他的人们又回到和他们在一起联谊了。
So he goes back again to drugs and free sex, and in this way he wastes his life.
他回去之后又开始喝酒，又开始自由的性，然后呢回到这种感官享乐的生活之中。
But he forgets about
浪费了他这一生。
He forgets about death, which is coming very soon.
他完全忘记了这个死亡会随时会立马就来。
So some people they're just like monkeys who live in the forest. They live, go from one tree to another.
有些人呢他就像一个猴子一样，他生活在这个猴，他在这个树里面，从一个到另一个树上。
Sometimes people think the monkey is very renounced because he's naked, he's living in the tree.
嗯，有些时候人们认为这个猴子很气绝，他生活在树上。
Yeah, he's naked.
很朴素。
He's naked, doesn't have any covering on him.
他没有穿衣服，也没有任何的这种，反正就是没有穿衣服。
But
这个猴子过得很简单。
The life of the monkey is just centered around sex and giving other people trouble.
但是呢，这个猴子就是给人造成麻烦的，像猴子这样的人就是给人造成麻烦的这样的人，因为他完全放纵于自己的性生活。
But some people are so foolish, they think, oh, these people, monkey, very renounced.
但是有一些愚蠢的人就会认为这些猴子非常的气绝，他生活在自由。
So sometimes people...They may get even some incurable disease.
有一些人呢，他会得到一些于是这样的一些人，他得了不治之症。
It's like falling into a mountain cave.
Falling into the
mountain cave, Shandong.
哦，就像掉进了山洞一样。
Yeah. So, if an elephant gets into the cave, it's very difficult for it to get out.
如果一个大象掉到山洞里面，是非常难以逃出来的。
You can't get the elephant to go backwards, get stuck in the cave.
他很难以从这个树上爬出来，从这个洞里面爬出来。
So, we see so many difficulties in material life.
我们看到这个物质生活充满了困难。
Just like some people are very attached to having sex.And they will have sex as much as they can with as many people as possible. And in this way they get disease.
我们看到有一些人特别喜欢享受性生活，尽可能的和更多的人去享受性生活，但是呢，他得了不治之症。
Just like an elephant stuck in the cave.
而这个就像在森林里面的一个大象，它掉到了山洞里面一样，无药可救。
Just afraid of death, waiting for death.
只能在这个山洞里面等死了。
So Jadbarat tells Maharaj Rahugan, he said, somehow the man may be able to get out of this dangerous position.
这个加德巴拉特就跟拉胡嘎说，有些时候这个人可能会逃离一些 非常危险的情况。
And he may be able to go back to his home, back to his family, and in this way, he will still be attached.
他逃离了这种危险的境况之后，他可能会回到家，也会回到他的家庭中，但是呢，他还是依附这种家庭的生活。
So he does not understand the real purpose of life.
这就是我们要理解这个人的生命的真正的目标是什么。
They're simply thinking life is for sense gratification.
对于他们来说，生活生命的目标就是感官享乐。
And they never cultivated any relationship with Vishnu or Krishna.
他们也不会培养和 Vishnu 以及 Krishna 的这种关系。
And they only think about money and material enjoyment.
他唯一想的就是钱以及物质的感官享乐。
So Jad Bharat tells the king, said,You're also like this. You're also attract. You have so much attraction to material pleasure.
Jadabara 就跟 Rahuga 说，你的情况也是这样，你对这个物质的生活也充满了依附。
So Jadabara tells the king. He said, "I advise you to give up your position as a king."
所以我给你的这个建议是放弃你的国王的地位。
Give up your attraction to all this sense pleasure.
放弃你对所有感官享乐的依附。
And cultivate devotional service.
培养奉爱服务。
Then you can get free of the illusory energy and you can come to real knowledge.
如此你才可以摆脱迷幻和虚幻的影响，得到真正的知识。
Just like in Bhagavad Gita in the 15th chapter, Lord Krishna describes about a tree.
就像在薄伽梵歌 Krishna 在第十五章之中， Krishna 把物质世界比喻为一棵树。
But he said the material world is the reflection of the tree.The real tree is some other place.
这个物质世界呢，就像这个树的一个倒影一样，而这个树在别的地方。
He said,
真正的树在别的地方。
He said, you have to cut down the tree, cut down this tree of attachment, of illusion, cut down the tree with the axe of detachment.
你应该砍掉这一个树，砍掉这种依附，以这种不执着为武器，砍倒这个根深蒂固的树。
He tells them that human life is the best of all. We're very fortunate to have the human body.
我们有这个人体生命是非常非常罕有的。
This human life is even better than the demigods in the heavenly planets.
我们这个人体生命甚至比天堂半神人的这个还要好。
Because the demigods there only got so much material attachment, sense gratification.
因为在半神人的这个天堂星宿里面，他们只是有感官享乐。
And they have.So much material comfort, so they don't get association with real devotees.
他们有很多的物质的舒适的条件，所以他们不会和奉献者产生真正的联谊。
So they don't spend their time in this material world.
所以他们不会和
Devotees don't spend their time in comfort and looking places where there's a lot of material comfort.
所以奉献者不会花很多的时间去寻找物质的舒适的环境。
They know that it's not good for their Krishna consciousness.
因为他们知道这对于他们的 Krishna 知觉并不是很好。
We need to do some austerity to get out this material world.
我们应该做一些苦行，为了我们应该为了离开这个物质世界而从事一些苦行的活动。
Okay, so we will stop here today.
好，我们今天讲到这里。
Are there any questions?
Yes, today. 第一个问题来自于Chandra Vani Devi Dasi. 请教孤儒，那遇到欺骗和不诚实的奉献者，还需要继续交往和发展吗？给奉献者借钱的，或者有生意利益的往来，好像关系就会很近；若没有这些利益的纽带，好像关系就非常的差。那么我们与奉献者之间的正常关系是怎样的？是不是最好不要发生钱的往来？感恩姑父的仁慈。
What's the first question?
He asked, when we meet some dishonest devotees, shall we continue to have a relationship with them?
We should be very cautious. We should be very cautious about dealing with people who are not honest.
我们应该非常小心和那些不诚实的奉献者交往。
If we know somebody is not honest, then we cannot trust them.
如果一些人他不诚实的话，我们不能相信他。So.Does she continue?
Yeah.
When we borrow some money to the devotees or have some business with them, then the relationship means get more close. But these business things, then the relationship will become very bad. So how to deal with the devotees, how to develop our real relationship with the devotees, is that we should not dealing some money with the devotees.
Yes, you're right. The relationship with devotees shouldn't be dealing with money.
是的，和奉献者不要有这种钱的这种纽带，不要发生这种钱的事情。
We should be very careful about lending money to people, giving money to other people.
我们要非常小心去借钱给别人，把钱给予别人。
Money belongs to Krishna. It's meant to be used for Krishna's service.
钱是属于 Krishna 的，那么呢，钱就应该用于对于 Krishna 的服务。
So we use it very carefully to try to expand the Krishna consciousness movement.
所以我们应该把钱用在很小心的用于 Krishna 知觉的运动之中。
So, when you do business, you have to be very careful about dealing with money.
当你做生意的时候，你也应该对钱特别的小心。
You lend people money, it's very difficult to get it back.
如果你借钱给别人，要拿到钱回来的时候是非常困难的。
Especially we can see at this time, where the business is very low, very slow, that people really desperate for money, you have to be very careful.
尤其在现在的这个情况下，这个经济呢发展非常 like the wedding, we should wedding or someone dead, we should give some money. So how to deal with these things for devotees?
Well, you can give some money, but you don't give much money. You give very small amount because it's not very important.
你可以给钱，但你不要给很多的钱。这不是一个很重要的事情。
Yeah, you may have to give some small amount because it's custom. Everybody has to give, so you give some small amount.
这是一种习俗的话，如果每个人都必须给钱的话，你就给一丁点的钱，不要给很多的钱。Next question.
Yeah.
Dimbai Guru, 最近不断有奉献者向我推荐一种网购团购的生意，有很多人通过这种生意在短时间内赚了一般人几十年上班赚到的钱，但是网购的商品有一小部分不适合奉献者用和推广，比如肉类、酒类等等，而且开始时会花很多的精力，后面会轻松一些。看到奉献者通过这一生意赚到的收入，我内心受到了诱惑。请问，我应该从事这一生意赚钱，为 Krishna 更好的服务吗？ Obeisance to Guru. Recently, devotees advised me some business. This business is internet shopping. Some people use this business.To get a lot of money in very short time, but this internet shopping have some things that are not good for the devotees. Like they selling the meat, they selling the wine. So and at the beginning it takes a lot of time and energy, but at later will become relaxed.So when I see some devotees use this business to get a lot of money, I moved. So should I use this business to make money for Krishna and serve better? Should I do this business?
Well, you have to decide for yourself if you can do it without being too much contaminated.
你应该自己决定，如果你真的想要做这个生意的话，你应该好好的想清楚，你是否能在做这个生意的过程中而不被很多的污染。
Yeah, just like we may want to go in to distribute books and we want to distribute Krishna consciousness, so there's so many other things also in the market. We cannot stop all the other.
派书或者说去传播这个 Krishna 知觉的时候，我们不可能阻止这个市场上的其他的这些事情。
So, you want to do business, you have to tolerate sometimes these kind of inconveniences.
如果你想做生意，你应该容忍一些不便的这种情况。She said this internet shopping, they sell internet business, they sell some roll, they sell some meat and wine,
yeah.
Alcohol.
Yeah. Well, that's going on everywhere.
这种情况确实到处都在发生。
You want to do business, you want to make some living, you have to decide what you can do.
你想做生意，那你就得选择你可以做什么。
You cannot think that you can stop. You will just find a place where you can just have only devotees and only everything very pure and clean.
你也不可能找到你又想做生意，然后只和奉献者在一起，这个地方又干净，什么都很好，只和奉献者在一起又干净的这种生活。
You want to do business, you have to expect there will be these kind of things.
你想做生意，你就得想好这些事情。你想做生意，你就不能期望这样的美好的这种刚刚所讲的这种情况。
还有呢
？OK， 怎么Hari from Hari Vinay Hari Vamsa Prabhu， 怎么确定自己是否掉进了物质存在的山洞，在等死呢？有时奉献者居士也感觉到自己在山洞里，有时在洞口，有时在洞外，有时感觉是在选择应该到洞里还是走出洞里。So how to know whether we are falling down the cave, the material cave, and waiting for the death?
We will know.
And sometimes the Grihastha devotees also feel we are in the cave. Sometimes in the cave, sometimes outside of cave, sometimes feeling we should decide whether we should go to the cave or go out of the cave.
We should know that goal of life is to get out of this, we have to get free of birth and death. We're in the material world and we're caught in the wheel of birth and death. We have to understand our situation.
我们现在就应该始终铭记我们的这个目标是为了脱离这种物质的生老病死的这种状况。同时我们也得了解现在我们自己的这个处境。
We have to have some consciousness of Krishna or Vishnu. We have to understand who is behind this world.
我们应该有一些 Krishna 和 Vishnu 的这个知觉，应该知道在这个世界之外的这个人是谁。
Lord Krishna created this material world for the illusion, not for the devotional, not really for his direct service, but it's for the illusion of the materialists.
Krishna, 我们应该知道 ，Krishna 创造这个物质世界是为了迷惑那些物质主义者，而不是真正的为了我们做奉爱服务的一个地方。
So we should be thinking how to get free from this world.
所以，对于我们来说，我们就应该思考如何真正的从这个情况，从这个物质的状况中得到解脱。
We have to have some consciousness of Krishna.
我们要有 Krishna 的这个知觉意识。
We have to do hearing and chanting.
我们要聆听和唱诵。
Not only just working and making money, we have to have some time to chant the holy name.
不要只是去赚钱，我们要花时间去唱诵圣名。
We should be thinking how to do service for Krishna.
我们应该思考如何为 Krishna 做奉爱服务。
Not just only how to get money to feed the family.
不只是赚钱来维系喂养这个家庭。
Okay.下一个问题。
下一个问题 ，from the Jagateshwari Mataji, obeisance to Gurudev, thanks translator. You mentioned some the fake guru, the boga.
Boga.
Before we really meet these things, so please.Guru Maharaj, can you explain more about this? And can you explain more? In the future, the real guru and the not real guru, this is what we should do and what we should what we should pay attention? Thanks, Guru Maharaj.
Yes. Well, the false guru is the one who is telling you that you don't have to follow any rules and regulations.
这种假咕噜呢，就会告诉你，你不需要遵循任何的规范守则。
The false guru is the one whose interest is just to have lots of followers and not to teach them proper knowledge.
一个假咕噜，他就只是关心我到底有多少的追随者，而不是考虑这些追随者，我给予了这些追随者多少的知识。
He doesn't teach them the scriptures.
他不教授这些人灵性的知识和经典。
He doesn't encourage them in the chanting of the holy name.
他不鼓励他们进行唱诵圣名的活动。
He may tell them to chant his name.
他可能会告诉这些门徒去唱诵这个灵性导师自己的名字。
And he's very happy to take their money.
而且他非常乐于接受钱，去拿到钱。
And he will use it for his sense gratification.
而且他拿着这些学生的钱用于感官享乐。
Okay.
Next question from Sati Mataji. 请问 Guru Dev, 出于保护自己的目的而养成了说谎的习惯，知道自己的这个习惯不好，但却总是不知不觉地说了假话，在这种情况下会怎样？如何根除呢？ So, a base to Guru Maharaj. When we want to protect ourselves, so we get a habit of the tell the lies. We know this habit is not good, but unconsciously we tell the lies. So in this situation, what's the future, and how to cut this, how to not do this again?
Okay, so certainly telling lies is certainly very bad. It creates a very untrustworthy atmosphere. It means you cannot trust someone who's a liar because you don't know when they're telling the truth and when they're lying.
说谎话呢，确实是一个很不好的事情。说谎话造成了一种很不好的氛围。比如说一个人说谎话的时候，你很难相信这个说谎的这个人他说的是一个什么样的情况，你无法真正的去相信他。
Yeah, he may say I'm telling you the truth, but you know that he also tells a lot of lies.
这个说谎的这个人，或许也会说我说的是真话，但是你无法相信这个说谎的人他说过的这句话，因为他经常在说谎。
So, it's a very bad habit, and we definitely want to stop. If you have that habit of telling lies, it's something very bad, and we want to feel very guilty about it.
如果你真的有这种习惯的话，这非常不好。你应该为这种不好的这种说谎的这种习惯感觉到很罪恶、很愧疚。
Because we're cultivating the mode of goodness. The mode of goodness means we should be truthful.
因为我们在培养善良心态，善良心态的意思是我们要说真话。
So if we have the habit to tell lies, then we want to apologize to people afterwards. I'm sorry, it's not true, I was telling a lie, I should tell you the truth.
如果我们真的说了谎话的话，我们就应该为这个谎话而感觉到道歉。你意识到的话，你就应该跟这个当时听到你这个话的人说，非常对不起，我当时说了谎话。
We should fall at their feet, beg forgiveness. Please help me, that I have the habit to tell lies. Please try to help me to correct my bad habit.
我们应该拜倒在他的足下，然后跟他说，请帮助我，让我不再说谎，我有这个说谎的这个毛病，请你们帮助我，让我以后不要再说谎。
We should pray to Krishna and cry and beg Krishna to help us to speak the truth.
我们应该向 Krishna 祈祷，向 Krishna 祈求，祈求 Krishna， 祈求 Krishna 能够帮助我们，让我们能说真话。
Only in very special cases you may have to tell lie to save someone's life.
只有在特别极少的这种情况下，你才可以这个说谎，而只是为了救他人的这种生命，救他人的情况下，拯救他人的时候，你可以说谎。
Okay.
好的。
还有问题吗？
没有问题了。
真的吗？没
有。还有一个问题。From the Haniwamsa Prabhu. 现在的人总感觉为家庭努力的挣钱永远不够，所以现在的人没时间用于觉悟自我。这就是物质的煽动吗？怎样恰当的拯救他人离开煽动？毕竟眼前煽动的人太多了。哦，这个是来自于一个手机新人。Nowadays, people usually feel should make a lot of money and never satisfy this money. It's not enough for them. They feel this money is not enough for them. So, and nowadays, people don't have time to self-realization. So, if that means this is the real meaning of the material keep,and how to help people to go get out of the cave, because many people are in the cave. How to help people get out of the cave?
We have to give them Krishna consciousness.
我们应该给予他们 Krishna 知觉。
We have to teach them the goal of life.It's not just to make money.
我们应该告诉他们，这个物质生活的目标不仅仅只是为了挣钱。
We should encourage people to live simple and cultivate higher consciousness.
我们告诉人们简单的生活，崇高的知觉和理想。
Don't just work.Don't just be only thinking of money and sex and family, not thinking about our spiritual life, about the soul.
不要总仅仅只是想着钱、性生活、家庭。我们应该知道我们的灵性的目标、人生的目标是什么。
We can see with things like the virus,going around the world, how easy it is for the whole world to be put into difficulty.
我们看到这个新冠病毒在全球蔓延，你会发现让这种让人们是就是很 how good it I can't remember. Sorry.
They're put into difficulties because they're only thinking about material situation.
就是说，如果他们只是想着物质的这种状况的话，他们是很容易陷入困难之中的。
They're only thinking their bank balance, how much money I have.
如果人们只是想着他的银行里有多少的存款，他的物质的境况的话，最终而言，这个物质，这个世界会给他很大的一个困难。
People spend so much money to buy motor cars, but then for so many months they could not drive their car. They just have to sit at home.
人们花很多的钱去买一辆摩托车，但是呢， 车放在那里几个月都不开，因为他不在家。
So like this, people, they have their material goals, but they don't have any spiritual goal. They don't have any spiritual vision.
人们有很多的这种物质的目标，但是对于灵性的目标，他没有，他没有灵性的这种视域。
So we have to try to preach, try to awaken people to spiritual life.
我们应该唤醒他们灵性的生活。
Now with this world situation, you know, the world economy is very down and there's not much business, there's not much activity.
现在我们整个全球的经济都处于一个很低迷的这个状况，人们之间的生意往来呢比较少。
So people have more time to chant and to read the books.
这种情况，人们就有很多的时间可以念诵，可以阅读。
So especially this week, the devotees all around the world, they're emphasizing more reading, trying to encourage everyone, read the books carefully.
尤其在这个星期呢，整个全球都鼓励人们更多的阅读经典。
And if they hear from Prabhupada's books, it can change their life.
如果他们能够聆听到圣帕帕德，可以阅读到圣帕帕德的书的话，这可以改变他们的生命。
Prabhupada's books have a very special power that they can turn people around. They can make them see the reality, see the truth.
圣帕帕德的书有很大的力量，它可以帮助人们看到这个世界的真实状况，可以看见真理。
So we should read the books, and we should try to encourage others also to read the books.
我们应该更多的阅读，我们同时应该鼓励他人更多的阅读这些书籍。
You should have a program, a fixed program, every day to read the book at a certain time.
你应该组织一个活动，或者安排一个时间，每天一起读书。
Just like Harivamsa, you have a family, so you should sit with your family and you should read the book to them every night.
所以 Harivamsa.你有你的家庭，你应该组织你的家庭，比如说每天晚上大家一起来读书。
Encourage them, encourage your wife to hear.
如此来鼓励你的妻子，鼓励他们去聆听。
I know sometimes women, when they have a child, they're very busy, so they don't take time to read.
我知道有一些女士有了孩子之后，她们非常的忙碌，根本没有时间去阅读。
So you have to read to her. You have to get her to hear. You take a book out and you read it to her.
所以呢，你应该拿起书为她而读，你应该读给她听。
You are her husband.You have a duty to lead your wife. Don't become a husband unless you can save your wife from birth and death.
你是她的丈夫，丈夫的职责，除非你能拯救这个人脱离于生死，否则你不应该成为一个丈夫。
So it's a responsibility.
这是你的责任。
You know.I also have responsibility. My responsibility is to you, to make sure you are Krishna conscious, to save you from birth and death.
我也有我的职责和责任。我的责任是让你脱离于生老病死。
So I'm telling you, you have to read the books every day.
我告诉你，你应该每天都读书。
You don't have to read all day, But you should read for 20 minutes or half an hour.
你不是说一整，不是让你一整天都读书，你至少一天要读二十分钟的书。
Okay, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Next from the Jamuna Priya Mataji, obeisance to Guru. 我们想为 Guru 做一些特殊的服务，取悦他。我们只是默默的祈祷，可以有这样的机会 ，Krishna 就会回应我们吗？还是我们先要向，需要向 Guru 寻求祝福和允许，再去做这些服务呢 ？So obeisance to Guru, Gurudev.Guru Maharaj, we want to do some special service to Guru Maharaj and please him. We just silently pray to get this chance and opportunities to have this, to opportunities to, this, to do this service. Then Krishna will give us reply or we should ask Guru Maharaj to get some permission to do this service.
Yes, you can ask, and you can also. Yeah, usually we would ask, get permission.
你可以向你的 Guru 去询问。
Usually, you want to do something, you're not sure, so you should ask the spiritual master, is this proper or not?
有些时候你想做一些事情，但是呢，你不是很确定，很犹豫，所以你就向你的guru去询问，这是一个很恰当的行为。
But we shouldn't spend all our time just asking Krishna to do these things.
We are not spending all the time to ask Krishna.
Yes, we shouldn't. Yeah, you don't have to spend a lot of time to ask Krishna.
我们不要花很多的时间去询问花费很多的时间去问 Krishna 这些事情。
We should do some practical service.
我们做一些实际的努力，实际的服务。
Do hearing and chanting.
聆听和唱诵。
Read Prabhupada's books.
阅读圣帕帕德的书。
And try to distribute Krishna consciousness.
然后努力去传播 Krishna 知觉。
Nice kirtan of the holy name is always attractive to people.
好的唱诵，然后呢，去吸引人们来参加这个。
So, the chanting of the holy name is also very beneficial for everyone.The chanting of the holy name is beneficial for everyone.
唱诵圣名对于每一个人来说都是非常好的。
Not just for the guru, for everyone.
不仅仅只是为了 guru, 会帮助到每一个人。
So try to give kindness to everyone.
不仅仅为孤儿，要为每一个人，把你的这种仁慈撒向所有的人。Okay, next question.
Yeah.
顶拜孤儿，请问我今天和一位奉献者联谊，他在做生意，大部分时间用于赚钱。请问我能提醒他吗 ？Obeisance to Guru Maharaj. Today I association with one devotee He used a lot of time to make money, and most of her time is to making the money. Shall I remind her?
Shall I remind her? Remember her?
Shall I speak to her or give some advice or mention to her not use so much time to make money?
If you're her guru, then you can mention to her. If you're not her guru, she won't want to hear from you.
如果你是她的灵性导师，你可以给她提出建议。如果你不是她的灵性导师，她不一定会听你的。
You have to know your position, and you have to know who you can instruct.
你应该知道你的位置，以及知道你可以训，可以给予谁训示。
So somebody is doing, they're doing business, that may be their job. But are they also chanting? Do they also take time in the morning to chant? Do they take time in the evening to worship? Are they doing business only 24 hours a day?
有些人真的是在赚钱，但是呢，他早上在念，晚上在崇拜，他是不是24小时都在赚，在从事赚钱呢？
You cannot criticize someone for doing their duty. If their dharma is to do business, you cannot criticize them.
如果有人的这个职责就是去赚钱，你不可以去批评他。
You have to consider what are they not doing? Are they chanting? Do they take time in the morning to worship Krishna?
你得好好的思考以及衡量他的这个情况，他早上有没有崇拜和念诵这个 Krishna 的圣名呢？你知道这个情况吗？
If somebody is able to do business and make money, it's very good.
如果有人能够赚钱维系赚钱的话是很好的。
They can do that for Krishna.
他可以为 Krishna 而做。
Why do you want to stop them?
你为什么要去停止他们，阻止他们？
Our duty is to remind people of Krishna.
我们的职责是our duty is to remind, 我们的职责是想着 Krishna.
Yeah, and we want to encourage other people also to remember Krishna.
或者帮助别人也想着 Krishna.
So we
鼓励别人也想着 Krishna.
We tell people about Krishna.
要想这么做的话，我们向别人讲述 Krishna.
But people also have to do their work. They have to do their jobs. They have to, if they're doing business, they make, okay. It's not a fault.
但是呢，他们也得做他们的职责。如果说他应该去赚钱或从事他们的生意的话，没有问题。Next question, Guru.
Yeah.
From the Nila Madhaji, Nila Devi Dasi, 顶拜 Guru, 作为奉献者，实在是不想在物质世界工作，与这些无神论者接触。因为会有很多的不方便，所以就不想去工作。但是不工作又没有钱，没有钱又不能在这个卡利年代生活，我们如何平衡这种关系呢？ Obeisance to Guru Maharaj, as a devotees, we really don't want to work in this material world and work with these atheist people, because they are very difficult and so many not convenient. So we don't want to, so that we don't want to work. But if we not work, we don't have money. And we don't have money, we can't live in this Kali Yuga. How to balance this relationship, this situation?
Yes. Yes, we agree. It's very difficult.
我们同意，这确实很难。
So you have to do good sadhana every day. Good sadhana in the morning before you go to work. You do good, try to do good chanting, try to do good hearing. And good in the evening also, try to hear, chant. It will protect you from the unpleasant association.
So my advice is, you need to be very good at practicing your sadhana, sadhana bhakti.
And you know this job you have, the job you have is not eternal. One day you will retire, you will leave that job.
你要理解到你的工作不是永恒的，有一天你还得离开你的工作。
So when you retire, then you can devote yourself fully.
当你退休的时候，你就可以完全的从事奉献服务了。
Okay.
Okay. From the next question from the Usha Mataji, 顶拜感恩咕噜实战的课程，感恩翻译和 YY 的小蜜蜂们。请问咕噜，咕噜的责任是拯救门徒，丈夫的责任是帮助妻子。经典说，女性奉献者也有责任带起不修行的丈夫。So thanks to Guru Maharaj practical lecture, and I want to ask, Guru's responsibility is to help people and help the disciples, to saving the disciples. The husband's responsibility is to helping his wife. The scripture also say the female devotees are also responsible for bringing up the non-practiced husband. Is that right?
Yes, that's right.
是的，这是正确的。
You do your best to help your husband. You prepare nice prasadam and encourage him.
你做尽可能的去做好你的修习，去帮助你的丈夫，比如说准备好菩萨的为你的丈夫。
Always try to help him to have a good impression about devotees.
总是让他们让你的丈夫对奉献者有一个很好的印象。
Speak nicely to him. Speak kind words.
对你的丈夫说一些好话，一些美好的话，对他。
Help him to develop an appreciation for devotees.
让你的丈夫能够欣赏奉献者，欣赏奉献服务。
So husband and wife, they share.Each other's pious activities.
丈夫和妻子之间会共同分享一些虔诚活动。
And they also share if they do sins. If one of them does sins, then the other one has to share some of that.
同时，他们也会共同承担一些恶报、罪恶的活动。如果其中一个人做了很罪恶的事情的话。
So you try to protect your husband from sinful activity.
所以你应该保护你的丈夫免于去从事这些罪恶的活动。
Okay.
Okay. Next question. So what is the relationship and the difference between the Radharani and Yoga Maya?
Radharani, 你没有讲中文。
请问 Radharani 和 Yoga Maya 之间有什么关系和区别？
Well, Yoga Maya is one of Krishna's energies for his different purposes. Sometimes Yoga Maya works in two ways. One way it covers up the non-devotees, and the other way it covers up devotees.
Yoga Maya is Krishna's 的一种能量，它有两种这种形式的方式。第一种呢，覆盖那些非奉献者，有些时候它也迷惑奉献者。
So Yoga Maya, she covers up the non-devotees. So the non-devotees, when they see Krishna, they think he's an ordinary person.
Yoga Maya 会覆盖那些非奉献者。当那些非奉献者看到 Krishna 的时候，他认为 Krishna 是一个普通的人物。
So think they can kill Krishna.
他还认为自己可以杀了 Krishna.
Like Kamsa thought he could kill Krishna.
就像 Kamsa 一样，他认为他可以杀了 Krishna.
But Yoga Maya also covers up devotees, so the devotees think of Krishna.Like their child, or like their friend, or like their lover.
有些时候 ，Yoga Maya 也会迷惑奉献者。这时候呢，奉献者就会认为 Krishna 是他的朋友，是他的爱人，是他的孩子。
We see that when Krishna took birth, Yoga Maya also came.
当 Krishna 降临出生的时候 ，Yoga Maya 也来了。
First of all, Yoga Maya transferred Lord Balaram from the womb of Devaki to the womb of Rohini.
这个 Yoga Maya 把这个 Balaram 从 Devaki 的子宫调到了 Rohini 的子宫之中。
And then when Mother Yashoda gave birth.She gave birth to Yoga Maya.
当亚修的妈妈姐生的时候，她生的是 Yoga Maya.
So when Vasudev came to the home of Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda, he changed the boy. Vasudev brought the boy from Dwarka, from Mathura. He brought the boy from.Mathura and left it in the home of Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda, and he took the giro. That giro was Yoga Maya.
Vasudev 从 Mathura 城带来了这个男孩，然后呢，把这个男孩和男孩给换，男孩放到了这个 Nanda Maharaj 和 Yashoda Mother 姐这儿，然后他带走这个女孩，这个女孩就是 Yoga Maya.
So Radharani is Krishna's Ladini Shakti. She's his pleasure potency. She's just meant for giving pleasure to Krishna.
Radharani is Krishna's Ladini Shakti, 就是他的喜乐能量。他的这个职责就是给予 Krishna 快乐。
So Radharani, she.Well, she's born in Varsana.
Radharani 出生在 Varsana.
And she's the daughter of Maharaj Vrishabhanu and Kirtida.
她是Maharaj Vrishabhanu 和 Kirtida 的孩子。
And she comes to take part in Krishna's pastimes because she gives pleasure to Krishna.
他来是为了参与这个 Krishna 的逍遥时光，他想给 Krishna 快乐。
She is the best of all the gopis.
他是所有的牧牛姑娘之中最好的。
Actually, all the gopis are expanded from Radharani.
所有的这个牧牛姑娘又是 Radharani 的扩展。
Just like everybody is expanded from Krishna. All the women are expanded from Radharani.
所有的人都是来自于 Krishna 的这个扩展，而所有的木流姑娘又是 Krishna 又是 Radharani 的扩展。
So there are many, many, many gopis. They all come, and the goddesses of fortune and the queens, they all come from Radharani.
比如说像幸运女神，然后还有其他的一些奉献者，它都是 Radharani 的扩展，都是来自于 Radharani。
So Radharani is the topmost person. She is worshipable even by Krishna. Krishna worships Radharani.
所以 Radharani 也是至高的这个人物，他甚至被 Krishna 所崇拜， Krishna 崇拜 Radharani。
Yoga Maya, she takes part in Krishna's pastimes as Purnamasi.
Yoga Maya 她在 Krishna 的这个逍遥时空中扮演的是 Purnamasi。
Anyway, there are many things to say about Yogamaya and Radharani. I've told you some things. I've told you some things to help you understand.
当然有很多的这个有很多的关于 Radharani 和 Yogamaya 要说的事情，我只说这一部分。希望能够帮助你理解。
Okay.
Okay.Next question from the Lanita. Last question.
Sorry, good day. 这位奉献者刚才问的就是关于这个 Yoga Maya 和这个 Radharani 的，他是想问，就是说 Radharani 是所有 Krishna 的能量的首领吗？他问这个 Yoga Maya 是不是来自于 Radharani 呢？
She wants to ask whether the Yoga Maya is come from the Radharani.
No.
不是的。
Yoga Maya comes from Krishna.
Yoga Maya 来自于 Krishna.
I never heard anywhere Yoga Maya comes from Radharani.
我从来没有听说过 Yoga Maya 是来自于 Radharani.
Yogamaya is one of Krishna's potencies.
Yogamaya 是 Krishna 的这个能量。
好的，那我想这位奉献者应该理解了。好的，谢谢 Good Day.
Okay. So, another question from the Lalita Prana. 顶拜孤儿的莲花族。现在我们身边有很多这样的情况下，妈的只是奉献者，但丈夫不是，所以想要离开家庭，认为这样的家庭阻碍了自己的灵性修习，这种心态好吗？还有一些情况是，我们年轻的妈的们想要结婚，但是身边的帕布又太少了，所以没有结婚的对象，那要怎么办呢 ？So a basis.
Okay. So.Yeah, they cannot leave the husband. If the husband's not a devotee, you're married to the man. If he may not be a devotee, you have to stay with them. We don't encourage women to get divorced.
So, the first question is,
you continue with your husband, and you...Like I said, you try to do it just like we told about Usha, that you encourage your husband to avoid sinful activity.
就像我前面给 Usha 的这个建议，你应该保护，你应该让你的丈夫去避免，尽量让他避免不要做罪恶的活动。
And you want a young girl wants to get married, but there's no man devotees?Well, they should cultivate the man to become a devotee.
第二个情况，这个年轻帕布又太少了，怎么结婚的问题就是，我们就是他应该去培养一个年轻的帕布，然后去结婚。 That means the Mataji should cultivate or...
Well, the Mataji, if she has some relationship with a man who is not a devotee, she should explain to the man that I'm a vegetarian, that if you're going to marry me, I'm a vegetarian, you will have to also be a vegetarian at home.
就是说, 这个年轻的Mataji, 如果有一个心仪的对象, 他想去结婚的话, 他有一个对象的话, 他应该告诉这个, 男的, 我现在是一个素食者, 如果你想和我进一步交往, 结婚的话, 你也应该成为一个素食者。
Yeah, he may have to eat meat outside, he may go outside, he may have association where he has to eat meat outside, but at home he should be vegetarian.
甚至有这样的甚至就是说你可就是这个男孩可能不得不在外面去吃肉但是呢他去外面吃肉或者在外面遇到一些什么样的人或情况但是呢回到家里必须是一个素食者。
The wife should explain to the husband that I'm not going to cook any meat for you at home.
这个年轻的男孩得给这个小伙子说，我不可能为你在家里做任何的肉食。
So just make it clear to the husband what your standards are. What make it clear to the man before the marriage.
结婚之前给这个男孩说清楚，说清楚你的标准是什么。我们这个家庭未来如果要建立的话，标准是什么？
But if the man is serious to marry, you know that you can explain. You cook very nice food, very nice vegetarian food, very nourishing, very nutritious.
你可以向这个你的未婚夫解释，你可以做很好的这个素食，很美味又营养的素食给他。And
the man can be satisfied.
这样的话，这个男的就会感觉到很满意，很满足。Okay. Okay. The last question from the Chatra David Dasi. 顶拜姑的莲花组感谢翻译，请问作为奉献者，每月给父母尽孝道的钱会不会有业报 ？Every month, she need to give the money to the parents. So this money will cause some karma.
Yeah.
是的，会产生一些业报。
You get karma for everything. Yeah, you can't avoid. Some karmas you can't avoid. You have a duty to your parents. You have some duty to them to give them money, then what can you do? You can't avoid it.
如果你有责任要给你的父母一些钱的话，你能做什么呢？你必须得给他们。
But you should encourage them not to use that money for sinful things, you know, to buy alcohol and to eat meat. It's not very good. Old people, in their old age, they should know they shouldn't be eating meat. It's not. Old people, they cannot digest meat.
作为一个老人，他应该知道，他不应该再吃肉了，因为吃肉对于一个老人来说很不容易消化。Anyway,
yeah. So you have to try to minimize your karma.
所以你应该尽可能的去减少你的 karma.
But some karma you can't avoid.
但是有一些 karma 你避免不了。
Okay, so we will stop here tonight.
Okay, 我们结束今天晚上，谢谢Guru Dev。
Thank you.
顶拜Guru Maharaj。
Thank you, Subhuti Rai. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Guru Dev.
Okay.
Hare Krishna, Dev.
Hare Krishna, Sati. Thank you.
好，谢谢，Good day， 谢谢Prabhu，好，也感谢大家。好，那我们今天的晚课就到这里结束了。Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。晚安。
晚安，Good day，take care。
Yeah.